So I'm Mark DeVellis, I'm a producer on Need for Speed. I was in charge of creating the HDE this year for Need for Speed Undercover. And one of the challenges this year was creating an action title that was very accessible with the physics. We wanted to create a whole bunch of crazy cool maneuvers that, you know, with essentially a flick of the button or a flick of the stick, can place into the hands of the user, you know, a very enjoyable, easy experience. So this year, we started off with a simple burnout. So essentially, you're just holding both the LT and RT triggers down, spooling up those tires, getting the smoke billowing out of the fenders there. And all I'm going to do here is just let go of the brakes, hold the throttle down, and bam, we're off. That essentially started, okay, that was pretty generic, where can we go from there? So we said, you know, start with a 360, so you do the same thing, you release the brake and you hold the steering all the way to one way. That puts the car into a, you know, beautiful 360. The camera stays stationary. First time ever where you're able to see the full 360 of the car. You see all that realistic suspension movement as we're going over the curb as well. It looks really beautiful and cool. Physics is all doing it naturally. Nothing's being faked, phonied. You know, we went basically from 40 attributes, say 6-7 years ago, to up to 400. Everything's based on curves, speed. We can tune essentially every parameter of the car. So then we got the the brakes down. We went to the 360. So then we said, why can't we do a 180? So essentially, with a flick of the e-brake and a flick of the steering, we're into a 180. Let's leave the camera stationary there, and all we have to do now, the camera's perfect for reverse driving. Camera rotates around, and now we're reverse driving. So it's very touchy, as in real life. You have to be really sensitive for the stick. Little taps will do, but now we're actually driving in reverse, something we've never ever had before in any Need for Speed. And essentially, you get a totally different perspective. You're looking at the front of the car now. So now that we have reverse driving, we said, okay, very cool. Can we do J-turns with a flick of a switch? So all we do is flick, boom, we're the other way. Let's see that combined. So let's go into a J-turn, goes into reverse, flick of a switch, boom, we're back, going the other way with the J-turn there. So then we said, okay, all that's separating now to do 360s is just doing that faster. So let's gather some speed here. So there's a perfect one there. So nice and sharp and crisp. Let's do one more to show it shows that that one wasn't a fluke. Nice and simple. There we go, nice and reactive. Just showing you how, you know, flicks of the switch and flicks of the controls allow you just to dance around, finesse the car. I'm going to show you now how that's possible. If you pretty much spin the car around in this light, first time again ever where you're able to see the side of the car completely, you'll notice the fenders here, how much suspension movement there is in the car. That's all happening naturally. That's all, you know, we have progressive springs, we have digressive shocks, we have roll bars, and we have everything based on speed. So we are able to go and diagnose problems in the car all the way through the development of our titles and essentially hand-tune each and every single car perfectly. And each one of the cars feels different. That's the other thing, you know, all-wheel drives feel different than fronts to rears as well. And within those categories, depending on weight, depending on wheelbase, depending on ride height, everything handles and has its own character. The other thing is drifting. We don't have, as per se, drifting modes of drifting. We have drifting right into the game mode. That was awesome, funneled right through. So I'm able to essentially go through a long corner. As long as I keep my throttle pinned and counter steer, I'm going to keep the drift going. So there you go. You saw drift right through that corner. So let's get some speed here again. Let's NOS. Counter steer, and you see as soon as I counter steer, boom, the car comes right out of it. When you don't counter steer, you go in, boom, you're gonna spin out the car. Physics thinks, okay, he's holding the e-brake long enough, he wants to do a maneuver, or he's, you know, you broke that traction point where you've gone past 100% of the tire and you're going around. So some other inputs that we put in that are very cool this year to give the player more control is the double tap feature. It's whenever you're coming up to a roadblock or you want to change directions quickly. You'll notice all I'm going to do here is double tap the brakes here. I'm in fourth gear, double tap, and I go instantly into reverse. This car is stopped, and I'm spooled already up to 50-60 miles per hour. That allows quick transitions, allows me to get away from cops, allows me to spin off cops super simple. The other thing that we put in is we catered really to NOS. Not only does NOS, you know, blow by the opponents, we also made it so the NOS puts the power to the ground. As I'm going into the drift, I can hit the e-brake, NOS at the same time. As you just saw, I just did a nitro drift there. The style points popped up. So again, show you, we're gonna drift, NOS at the same time, and I'm NOSing and counter steering at the same time to really keep the drift going. So timing is crucial, timing is key. Like I can't stress enough, nothing is faked. It has been my duty over the last 7-8 years, since Hot Pursuit 2, we're developing Underground to create a physics engine that was powerful. All that work is a culmination of what we made in Need for Speed Undercover.